Numbers chapter 21. When the king of Aram, the Canaanite who lived in the Negev, heard that Israel was coming along the road to Athari, he attacked the children of Israel and captured some of them. Then Israel made this vow to Yahweh.
If you will deliver these people into our hands, we will completely destroy their cities.
Yahweh listened to Israel's plea and delivered up the Canaanites. They utterly destroyed them and their cities. So the name of that place was called Horma, meaning utter destruction. Then they journeyed from Mount Hor by the way of the Red Sea to go around the land of Edom. But the people grew impatient along the way. They spoke against Yahweh and against Moshe and said,
"Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in this wilderness? There is no bread, there is no water, and we detest this miserable food."
And Yahweh sent venomous snakes among them. They bit the people, and many of the people of Israel died. So the people came to Moshe and said,
"We have sinned when we spoke against Yahweh and against you. Pray that Yahweh will take the snakes away from us."
So Moshe prayed for the people, and Yahweh said to Moshe,
"Make a snake and put it up on a pole. Anyone who is bitten can look at it and live."
So Moshe made a bronze snake and put it up on a pole. And when anyone was bitten by a snake and looked at the bronze snake, he lived. Then the children of Israel moved on and camped in Abba. Then they set out from Abba and came to E-Abarim in the wilderness, which is east of Moab, toward the sunrise. From there, they moved on and camped in the valley of Zered. They set out from there and camped alongside the Arnon, which is in the wilderness, extending into the territory of the Amorites. The Arnon is the border of Moab, between Moab and the Amorites. That is why the book of the wars of Yahweh says, "Wahab in Suppah, and the ravines, the Arnon, and the slope of the ravines that reaches to the dwelling of Ar, and lies on the border of Moab." From there, they continued on to Baer, the well where Yahweh said to Moshe,
"Gather the people together, and I will give them water."
Then Israel sang this song.
Spring up, O well, all of you sing about it. The well the leaders dug, dug by the nation's nobles, by the lawgiver with their stays.
And from the wilderness they went to Matana, from Matana to Nahalyah, from Nahalyah to Bamoth, and from Bamoth to the valley in Moab, where the top of Pisgah looks down on the wasteland. Then Israel sent messengers to Sihon, king of the Amorites, saying,
"Let us pass through your country. We will not turn aside into any field or vineyard, or drink water from any well. We will travel along the king's highway until we have passed through your territory."
But Sihon would not let Israel pass through his territory. He gathered all his people together and came out against Israel in the wilderness. When he reached Yatzah, he fought with Israel. Then Israel defeated him with the edge of the sword and took possession of his land from the Arnon to the Yabbok, as far as the people of Ammon, because the border of the Ammonites was fortified. So Israel captured all these cities, and Israel occupied them, including Heshbon and all its surrounding settlements. Heshbon was the city of Sihon, king of the Amorites, who had fought against the former king of Moab and had taken from him all his land as far as the Arnon. That is why the poets say, "Come to Heshbon and let it be rebuilt. Let Sihon's city be restored. For fire went out from Heshbon, a flame from the city of Sihon. It consumed Ar of Moab, the citizens of Arnon's heights. Woe to you, O Moab! You are destroyed, O people of Chemosh. He has given up his sons as fugitives and his daughters as captives to Sihon, king of the Amorites. But we have overcome them. Heshbon has perished as far as Dibon. Then we laid waste as far as Napha, which extends to Medeba. So Israel lived in the land of the Amorites. After Moshe had sent spies to Yatzah, the children of Israel captured its surrounding settlements and drove out the Amorites who were there. Then they turned and went up along the road toward Bashan, and Og, king of Bashan, and his whole army marched out to meet them in battle at Edrei. Yahweh said to Moshe,
"Do not be afraid of him, for I have handed him over to you, along with his whole army and his land. You shall do to him as you did to Sihon, king of the Amorites, who lived at Heshbon."
So they defeated him, his sons, and all his people, until there were no survivors left, and they took possession of his land.